इज एवरीवन इज
यस मैम
हियरिंग?
स्टार्ट।
ओके ओके। अस्सलाम वालेकुम, आई एम डॉक्टर नाजिया हकीम, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर यूनिट 1 DIMC। टुडे ऑफ योर टॉपिक इज एक्टोपिक प्रेगनेंसी। सो बिफोर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट द टॉपिक ऑफ द एक्टोपिक प्रेगनेंसी, यू शुड नो द नॉर्मल फिजियोलॉजी ऑफ द नॉर्मल इम्प्लांटेशन ऑफ द ओवा और जायगोट। So, where is the normal implantation of the zygote? Normally, the ova is picked up by the ovary and the sperm is picked up by the femoral of the fallopian tube. So, what will happen with the flagellated movement of the tubes? The ova and the sperm will meet in the mid length of the fallopian tube, and then the two cell stage and three cell stage, which is known as the zygote, is made up, and then it will move forward toward the uterus, and the zygote will be implanted at the fundus of the uterus. This is the normal physiology of implantation of the normal zygote. So what will happen in the ectopic pregnancy, and what is the definition of the ectopic pregnancy? There is implantation and the development of a pregnancy or zygote in any site other than the endometrial cavity. Means the implantation is not occur at the fundus of the uterus. Endometrial cavity is a funnel of the uterus, but it is implantation outside the uterus. So what will be the three major sites of the ectopic pregnancy? Basically, the tubal implantation is more than the 95%. The incidence is 95% in the tubes. And the others, which are less than 5%, like ovarian, there could be the ovarian ectopic pregnancy. There could be the cervical, on cervix, there could be the cervical pregnancy. There could be the abdominal pregnancy. The zygote can be implanted into the abdominal cavity. And heterotrophic. What do you mean by heterotrophic? Heterotrophic pregnancy means then ectopic pregnancy is combination with the intrauterine pregnancy when there are two zygote occurred. One is in the normal position in the uterus and the other in with the extrauterine, it's and other sites. So in tubal pregnancy, what is the normal sites of the tubes? There are two fallopian tubes which is attached with the uterus. The part which is from the uterus to the femoral end is the interstitial part, stemness, ampullary, and the femoral end. So most common ectopic pregnancy will occur in the ampullary part of the fallopian tube, which is around 55%. The other than the stemic part, which is 25%, and the femoral part, which is 17%, sorry, and the institutional, which is close to the uterus, is a 2%. So the major part of the ectopic pregnancy will be occurred in the tubes. And the less than 5% can be occurred outside the tubes, like ovary, cervical, abdominal, and the heterotrophic pregnancy. So what could be the possible etiology? As you know, what could be the possible etiology? As you know, the physiology of the normal implantation, that the ovary, ova, and sperm will be picked up by the femoral end of the fallopian tube. In fallopian tube, there are the smooth muscle fibers, and that there are two fallopian tubes, and tubes are dynamic in nature. There are the flagella, which is the flagellated movement of the tube will pass the zygote toward the uterus. So anything happen which hampers the, which resists the movement of the flagellated movement of the uterus of the fallopian tube, or anything which causes the smooth muscle decrease movement, so there will be the zygote will be impacted into the tubes and the ectopic pregnancy will occur. So what could be the etiological factors? Could be the etiological factors, there could be a tubal factors like any previous tubal surgery and pelvic infection. So what will happen in the previous tubal surgery? Like if the patient has a previous ectopic pregnancy, laparotomy, has a previous any surgery in her tubes, she will give the history of the previous surgery abdominal. So what will happen? There could be the, you know, in every surgery, there could be the normal inflammatory process that occur, and a normal necrosis and adhesion formation can occur. So what will happen if there is a patient has a previous tumor surgery or any previous abdominal surgery? There will be the inflammatory process, there will be the adhesion formation, and there will be the adhesion formation around the tube. So it will hamper the normal flagellatory movements of the tubes and normal smooth muscle movement of the tube. So what will happen if there is the adhesions around the tubes, which causes the tubes to be stick together? So there will be no movement of the zygote towards the tube into the uterus, and the zygote will be impacted in any part of these tubes, and it will grow, and which causes the ectopic pregnancy, like in other pelvic infection. So how pelvic infection will cause the tubes? What will happen in the pelvic infection? The patient came with a complaint of the repeated vaginal infection. So what will happen in any vaginal infection? The infection will spread through the vagina to the cervix and to the uterus, and then it will spread into the fallopian tube or any other abdominal infection, like if the patient has some abscess in the pelvis, or some laparotomy has been done due to the ascites, due to the abdominal infection, due to any abdominal surgery, the infection will be spread into the tubes, and it causes the adhesion necrosis. So the flagellated movement of the tube is also impacted by these pelvic infection. So the major cause of the major etiology is the tubal factor. Other than the tubal factors are maybe the chromosomal abnormality. So in chromosomally abnormal pregnancy, likely to implant in the oviduct or into the fallopian tube. Like if the zygote is chromosomally abnormal, it cannot be moved through the tube in the uterus, and it will be implanted into the tubes. Exogenous hormones, like if the patient or woman on progesterone only pills, have decreased smooth muscle contractility, because the progesterone has an action on the smooth muscle, and it will decrease the mobility of the smooth muscle fibers. And as you know, the tubes are made up of the smooth muscle fibers. So what will happen if the patient has a history of taking so much progesterone pills for any reason, due to any other gynecological pregnancy? So it can cause the damage to the smooth muscle fibers and decrease the contractility of the smooth muscle and tubes. And it will also causes the impaction of the zygote in the tubes. Other than the IUCD, what is IUCD? This is the intrauterine contraceptive device. If the patient has an intrauterine contraceptive device for the contraception, but there is a failure rate, there is also failure rate of the IUCD. So what will happen if the pregnancy occur? It will impact it into the tubes, because in the endometrial cavity, there is an intrauterine contraceptive device, but the patient has a pregnancy, the zygote cannot be entered into the uterus due to the IUCD, and it will impact it into the tubes, and it will cause the ectopic pregnancy. Smoking is also causes the decreased flagellated movement and decreases smooth muscle fiber contractility of the tubes, and the history of the previous ectopic pregnancy. If the patient has a history of the previous ectopic pregnancy, so there is a high risk that the next pregnancy can end up into the ectopic pregnancy. So basically, these are the major etiological factors for causing of the ectopic pregnancy. The most common is the tubal factors, in which there is a history of the previous tubal pregnancy, or pelvic inflammatory disease, pelvic abscess, previous history of the laparotomies due to any abdominal surgery, any unsterilized condition which is in which the instruments are used, which will causes the infection into the pelvis, into the abdominal cavity, which causes the adhesion formation around the tube, which impact the normal flagellated movement of the uterus. So how the patient will present in your ER or in a OPD. So there will be the female of the reproductive age presenting with a positive pregnancy test, because you know the pregnancy reproductive age, the patient postmenopausal woman obviously cannot enter into the ectopic pregnancy. So the patient can present with a positive pregnancy test or without the positive pregnancy test. and pelvic pain, has an ectopic pregnancy unless proved otherwise. Symptoms: pain, unilateral pelvic pain, generalized pelvic pain, shoulder tip pain due to subdiaphragmatic irritation from the intra-abdominal blood. The patient can present with a different type of the pain. Maybe there is a low side pain, maybe there is a some unilateral pain. If the tubes have been ruptured, there will be the generalized pelvic pain. What is shoulder tip pain? If there is a tubes has been ruptured, so blood will go into the abdominal cavity, not through the vagina, but otherwise the blood will go into the spill into the peritoneal cavity. So what will happen when there is a huge amount of the blood is collected into the abdominal cavity? It will causes the irritation of the subdiaphragm. So what will happen? The patient is typical gave you the history of the shoulder tip pain. So pain in the ectopic pregnancy, there is a more than 90% the patient came with a complaint of the pain and bleeding. There is a vagina bleeding only occurs in a 75% of the cases. Bleeding, there is a mild vagina bleeding. In ectopic pregnancy, there is a mild vagina bleeding with the increased amount of the pain. And patient can present in a collapse form, depends of the amount of the intra-abdominal bleed. Like the patient has a ruptured ectopic pregnancy, there is a huge amount of the hemoperitoneum blood in the abdominal cavity. What will happen? There will be the decreased blood flow, there will be the decreased blood pressure, increased pulse rate. So patient can come to you in an emergency department with the collapse form, with the hypovolemic shock. So the clinical presentation of the ectopic pregnancies varies, depend on the site of the pregnancy and depend when this is a ruptured or unruptured. Okay, so what could be the differential diagnosis of the patient came with a positive pregnancy test and pain and the bleeding? So there are three differential diagnoses in early pregnancy. One is the miscarriage, the second is the ectopic pregnancy, and third is the hydatidiform mole. So how you will differentiate between the ectopic pregnancy and the bleed and the miscarriage? Obviously, the miscarriage, in miscarriage, there is also a reproductive age group woman. There is also a positive pregnancy test, but in the miscarriage, normally the patient has an increased amount of the bleeding and less amount of the pain. But in the ectopic pregnancy, there is a 95% pain and there could be a mild bleeding PV because the blood is gone. If there is a ruptured ectopic pregnancy, blood will spill into the abdominal cavity, not into the vagina. And in the miscarriage, the blood which is coming from the uterus, because there is a bleeding from the normal zygote. So blood will come from the uterus. So it is very important to diagnose the ectopic pregnancy timely before rupture, because if there is a rupture occur, there will be the bleeding. There could be the massive amount of the bleeding. The patient can went into the hypovolemic shock, and there is an increased mortality of the patient due to ectopic pregnancy. So what could be the signs? We will give you the answers after finishing the lecture through the chat. Okay. First of all, you just listen and then ask me the questions. Okay. What will be the signs? Signs of the ectopic pregnancy could be the acute abdomen. Acute abdomen, what do you mean by acute abdomen? Acute abdomen where there's a massive abdominal pain with a guarding and rigidity. When acute abdomen occurs, if there is a collection in the abdominal cavity like blood and with pus. So in ectopic pregnancy, if the tubes have been ruptured, there will be the blood into the abdominal cavity. Depend upon the amount of the bleeding, the patient can present you with the acute abdomen with the guarding. And when you will do the pelvic examination, there will be the pain during the movement of this cervix, which is known as the cervical excitation. Adnexal mass. What do you mean by adnexal mass? Adnexa means tube and ovary. Adnexa, what is the meaning of adnexa? Tubes and ovaries. There are two tubes and two ovaries in every patient, in every woman. So what will happen is there, if there is a one side of the tubal pregnancy and there is a, could be the ovarian, there will be the mass. There will be the mass of any size, maybe 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, depend on the size of the rupture. So you can assess on pelvic examination, could be the right or left sided, any mass. And patient can went कैन केम विद द साइन ऑफ द कार्डियोवैस्कुलर कोलैप्स टू द हैवी अमाउंट ऑफ द इंट्रापेरिटोनियल ब्लड. सो दीज आर द डिफरेंट साइंस ऑफ द एक्टोपिक प्रेगनेंसी. सो हाउ यू विल डायग्नोज द एक्टोपिक प्रेगनेंसी. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, इफ द पेशेंट came with a positive pregnancy test, or if the patient doesn't know, because sometimes the patient is not overdue, or maybe 1 or 2 days overdue, or she doesn't know ki I am pregnant. The patient came in a ER with a pain, bleeding, and low BP, high pulse. So first of all, whenever there is a reproductive age group of the woman came in a ER with a pain, mild bleeding, and severe abdominal pain, right-sided, left-sided, you should suspect the pregnancy. So, how you will confirm the pregnancy? You will do the during pregnancy strip test, or you will go for the serum beta HCG. First of all, you have to confirm the pregnancy, because in the other non-biological causes, the patient, then you will exclude it after doing the pregnancy test. If there is a negative pregnancy test, then there will be the there could be the other differential diagnosis, like there could be the acute appendicitis, there could be the torsion of the ovarian cyst, there could be the other abdominal pathology. So you have to exclude by pregnancy test. Then you will go for the further investigation. Then what would be the other investigation? Urine pregnancy test, full blood count, obviously, group and safe serum or prospect blood, all investigation, ultrasound path. Okay. So, why you will do the ultrasound pelvis? If the ultrasound inconclusive, serial HCG serves two purpose. Okay? Means if the patient is and you have an ultrasound facility, you can go for immediate ultrasound pelvis to determine the site of the ectopic pregnancy and amount of the bleeding. Okay. Then the progesterone level. Normally we are not doing progesterone level, because if there is a low level, progesterone level will tell you the status of the pregnancy. If the progesterone levels are low, it means ki the pregnancy is failing, and if the high levels, it means the pregnancy is going well. But in ectopic pregnancy, we only do the two investigation, the beta HCG, serum beta HCG or urine pregnancy test, and the ultrasound pelvis if the patient is vitally stable, and the CBC, full blood count, arrange and save the blood for at least 4 units of the blood and 4 units of the FFPs if there is a patient came in to you in a collapse form, because you have to go for the laparotomy, or with the blood group, you should know the blood group, hepatitis profile, and ultrasound pelvis if indicated. If there's a clinical indication, the patient is in the circulatory collapse, you have diagnosed this is ectopic pregnancy by urine pregnancy test, the abdomen is, patient came with the acute abdomen with guarding rigidity, and there's a positive pregnancy test, you don't have to need to go for the ultrasound. You just arrange the blood and you have to go for the surgery. So basic investigation are urine pregnancy test, complete blood count, arrange the fresh frozen plasma, blood grouping, and ultrasound. So what could be the management of the ectopic pregnancy? There are the three management of the ectopic pregnancy: the expected management, the medical management, and the surgical management. So what would be the expected management? What do you mean by expected? That leave the patient, there is no medication, you just observe the patient. So what are the criteria of the expected management? If the patient is asymptomatic and hemodynamically stable, she is maintaining her vitals, she is clinically asymptomatic, there is no pain, only mild pain. Okay, the beta HCG low and falling less than 1000 unit, international unit per liter. If the beta HCG is low, less than 1000, because in a normal pregnancy, above 1500 international unit, the pregnancy is appeared. So if the beta HCG is less than 1000, or it is falling into reading, then you can leave the patient And if there is a less than 100 ml blood in the pouch of the ductus, what is the pouch of the ductus? Basically, the pouch of the ductus is a space behind the uterus and cervix. So if there is a, means there is a, only the little amount of the blood in the pouch of the ductus, there is no worry that there is a major intra-abdominal bleed. If the beta HCG is falling, patient is asymptomatic, you can leave the patient, and there is no fetal heartbeat. In ultrasound, you can find a mass. The initial sac diameter is less than 2 cm. If the diameter sac is less than 2 cm and there is no fetal heartbeat and patient is hemodynamically stable, beta HCG is less than 1000, so you can leave the patient without any treatment, but you have to counsel the patient. There is the value of the counseling, that you have a regular human chorionic gonadotropin levels 2 weekly till the HCG is less than 20, and there will be the weekly transvaginal ultrasound. And you have to counsel the signs of the acute abdomen, like acute abdomen signs of the rupture, like acute abdomen signs, severe acute abdominal pain, guarding, rigidity, low BP, high pulse. So you have to counsel the patient that we are going to expected management, because these you are entering into the disease criteria, but you have to only do the beta HCG regularly, do the transvaginal ultrasound, and if there is a sign of the acute abdominal, you will go immediately to the hospital for immediate admission and may need the surgery. Provide the clean written information and importance of the compliance with follow-up. Okay, then the second one is the medical management. What do you mean by medical management? What will be the criteria? The criteria are women able to comply with dose follow-up. Then the patient, the compliance is very important. If you assess if the patient is not compliant, she cannot admit it in the hospital and she will not visit frequently after the medical management, then there are risk of the rupture. Patient can collapse at home. So you should know the patient is well compliant and well aware of the procedure with a close follow-up. In a sac, there should be no fetal heart rate activity. The beta HCG should be less than 3000, but more than 1000. Patient should be hemodynamically stable, and the size of the pregnancy is 3 cm up to 3 cm. Okay. And the success rate of this medical management is 90% if there is a proper compliance of the patient. What we will use in the medical management, we will use the metotrexate injection. Metotrexate basically is an anti-cancer drug which causes the degradation of the zygote or sac size within the uterus, within the sorry, fallopian tube, and it will be absorbed into the peritoneal cavity. So this is used in the form of the injection. The strength of the injection is 50 milligram per meter square. Basically, it is calculated with the in respect with the weight of the body, okay, how much injection has been given. Basically, it is calculated 1 milligram per kg. So if the patient is weight of around 50 kg, then one injection is enough for the patient. So followed by the serial beta HCG should fall by 15% between 4 and 7 days after injection. So you have to follow the patient with the serial beta HCG. You will do the beta HCG after 72 hours of the giving the metotrexate injection, and then the day 7. And if this fall by 15%, then this shows whether there is a success. Metotrexate is going to success. 7% may experience tubal rupture during the follow-up. So there is a 7% incidence of the tubal rupture. 14% will require the repeat dose, and 10% may require the surgery. So this is the basically the medical management, and it is very successful, but you have to counsel the patient. There should be the written consent for the medical management. Patient should be compliant. Either the patient should be admitted for 24 to 48 hours to see the response of the metotrexate, and if she is clever enough and can follow up in hospital in case of the emergency. So you have to counsel the patient with signs of the rupture. And there's a 90% success, and you know there's only a 7% experience tumor rupture. Okay. So what will be the surgical management? There is two types of the surgical management, laparotomy versus laparoscopy. What do you mean by laparotomy? Laparotomy means you are going to open the abdomen. And laparoscopy, as you all know, this is a basically a method under GA through the abdominal cavity, through the telescope, in which there is small incision has been given. And through laparoscope, you can remove the part of the ectopic pregnancy through the tube. So what is the criteria of the laparotomy? In hemodynamically stable women, the patient who are stable or who are not going to bleed, means if you are putting the laparoscope in the abdomen, there should be no bleeding. So the patient should be hemodynamically stable. There is no bleeding into the abdominal cavity. So laparoscopic is a gold standard. So what will be the, could be the advantage of the laparoscopy? There's a less blood loss, lower analgesia requirement, shorter hospital stay, patient can be discharged at evening, quicker post-op recovery because there is a low scar mark. Okay, lower cost, no, laparoscopy is a cost effective, laparoscopy is expensive, okay, and lower risk of the adhesions. But the main disadvantage is that you cannot do it in a hemodynamically unstable patient. You cannot do it in a major intraperitoneal bleed. There is expertise available. You have an instrument available, skills available, and cost effective. The other method in a laparotomy, in which you are going to open the abdomen through the surgical incision and you have to remove the ectopic pregnancy. So in women who are hemodynamically unstable, means those women who there are the rupture ectopic pregnancy, there are the bleeding in the abdominal cavity, there is acute abdomen, there is a shoulder tip pain, the patient is hemodynamically unstable, the patient is going into shock. So you don't have a time for laparoscope. So you will go straight for the laparotomy. So laparotomy is the treatment of the choice. So what could be the options in the laparotomy? In the laparoscopy is a self-injectomy versus self-injotomy. So what do you mean by self-inj? Self-inj is known as the tube. Self-inj means tube, fallopian tube. Jectomy means G-E-C-T-O-M-Y, that you are cutting clamp and cutting and remove the part of the tube. As self-injotomy means G-O-T-O-M-Y, jotomy means you just open the tube and remove the ectopic pregnancy content and leave it behind. Means you are not cutting and removing the part of the tube. So how you will decide if you are going for the self-injectomy or the self-injotomy? Self-injectomy means removal of the fallopian tube along with the ectopic pregnancy. And self-injotomy, there's a linear incision on the anti-mesenteric border and extraction of the ectopic pregnancy. So self-injotomy should be done when contralateral tube is damaged or absent and family is not complete. Means that the patient has no kids before and the other tube is also very bad, very badly and damaged or absent or badly adherent, and you are suspecting that if I will remove this tube, the patient will not be pregnant again. So I can do the procedure of the self-injotomy, only remove linear incision on the anti-mesenteric border of the tube and the extraction of the EP, ectopic pregnancy. But what could be the side effects of doing the self-injotomy? There will be the increased risk of the recurrent ectopic pregnancy, persistent. Means if you leave the tube behind it, so what will happen? There is an opening in the tube, you will not stitch back. So what will happen? If you leave the tube as it is, there will be the adhesion formation and there is an increased chances of the future ectopic pregnancy in that tube. So you have to counsel the attendant, you have to counsel the out if the patient has a other electric tube is also damaged, and you will take the written consent for doing the sulfangiotomy because there is increased risk of the chances of the ectopic pregnancy. And or if the tube is badly ruptured, there is no space for doing the sulfangiotomy, then you will take the consent from the spouse, from the attendant, and that this can happen because the patient will come due the future fertility issues. So you have to counsel the patient for sulfangiotomy. Okay. So these are the different management of the ectopic pregnancy. So basically, ectopic pregnancy is a clinical diagnosis. Clinical diagnosis, you have to diagnose clinically, then you have to decide expectant management, medical management, and the surgical management. And what is the difference between the medical and surgical management? According to the different studies have been done on medical management and surgical management. So there is no difference on the patient outcome of the medical management and the surgical management. The outcome of the both are same. So as a clinician, you have to decide if the what about the compliance of the patient, what about the awareness of the patient, about the follow up of the patient, how much follow up the patient can. After, if the patient is taking medical management, then he can or she can take it because there is no difference of the expected and medical management. So the future reproductive performance, 70% of the women will have the intrauterine pregnancy after ectopic pregnancy. There is a good outcome. Risk of the repeat ectopic pregnancy depends on state of the remaining fallopian tubes, like if you are doing the sulfangiotomy. If you are doing the sulfangiotomy, then there's an increased risk of the future ectopic pregnancy, and you have to counsel the spouse. All women who have an ectopic pregnancy should have an early pregnancy scan to confirm the location in subsequent pregnancies. The woman, you should counsel the patient. You should counsel the patient that at the start, then whenever you will be pregnant, you will come early in a OPD for confirmation of the site of the pregnancy because she is an increased risk for future ectopic pregnancy. So this is the end of the lecture. If anyone wants to ask the question, can done in a chat. There's a one question that, can you please again explain how PID, pelvic inflammatory disease, is causing ectopic pregnancy? Okay. What will happen in the pelvic inflammatory disease? The patient, and what could cause the pelvic inflammatory disease? There, as you know, there are different organisms like Chlamydia, gonorrhea, trichomonas, bacterial vaginosis, and a fungal infection. If the patient is causing the repeat vaginal infection due to multiple risk factors, so what will happen? The infection will spread through the vagina. Where the infection comes? From the uterus. So what will happen if you are not treating the uterus? It will cause the endometritis, means infection in the endometrium. Then what will happen? The infection will spread through the fallopian tube. As you know, there are two tubes which are attached at the lateral side of the uterus. And there is an interstitial part of the fallopian tube which is open. So what will happen? The infection will spread through the tubes. It will through the interstitial parts of the tube, then it will travel back into through the fimbrial end. And what will happen? The fimbria, there is a flagellated movement. The pus will be going through the fimbria into the abdominal cavity. And what will happen? There's a pus formation. There will be adhesion formation. There will be the adhesions around the tubes. So what will happen? There will decrease movement of the flagellated part of the tube and the ectopic pregnancy can occur. Okay. Anyone who want to question? Usually in a routine, we only do the two investigations to confirm the pregnancy, like urine pregnancy strip test or a serum beta HCG. Beta HCG is 100% reliable. Serum human chorionic gonadotropin, the report can come within two or three hours. And the second investigation is a ultrasound pelvis, either the transvaginal or the transabdominal, which facility are available. to confirm the pregnancy. Because first of all, you have to confirm the pregnancy, then you will go for the site, you know, the site of the pregnancy, for the ectopic pregnancy. If the patient is stable, she can go for the ultrasound. So we can decide if the patient can put in the medical management or the surgical management. Rest of the investigation, like full blood count, these are the baseline investigation. You have to arrange the blood, full blood count, hepatitis profile, random blood sugar, and blood group. In expected management, do we give methotrexate or the SAC involved? No. In expected management, there are criteria. The SAC size should, the beta HCG should be lower than the 1000, and the SAC size should be 2 cm, and there is no fetal heart. So you will not do the methotrexate. When you give the methotrexate, this will be the medical management, in which the beta HCG should be 1500, more than 1000. Laparotomy procedure. Laparotomy procedures mean there are two procedures, self-injectomy and self-angiotomy. What you will do the laparotomy? Laparotomy will done under the GA, general anesthesia, you will cut the abdomen, you will drain all the blood, because laparotomy, in laparotomy you are doing in an unstable patient. You will suck all the blood, and then you can do the two procedures, self-injectomy and self-angiotomy. Self-injectomy means you are cutting the tube and removing the tube along with the ectopic pregnancy, and then will stitch back. And self-angiotomy means you will only give the linear incision on the anti-mesenteric border of the tube to only remove the ectopic pregnancy, and you will leave the tube as it is. No stitch, no cutting. If the tube ruptured, then what will be the choice? Laparoscopy, laparotomy. Yes. If the tube has been ruptured, then there will obviously be bleeding. So you will assess clinical on the ultrasound. If there is an acute abdomen, there is a shoulder deep pain, this denotes that there is a massive amount of the blood in the abdominal cavity. The laparoscope cannot pass into the abdomen, because when you'll pass the laparoscope, what will happen? There is a blood and you cannot see with the blood. So in a ruptured ectopic pregnancy in which there's a huge amount of the bleeding, then you cannot go for the laparoscopy. The choice will be laparotomy. Okay. Any other question? I think this is a very small, interesting topic, but basically this is a basically clinical topic, no? Clinical. Laparotomy can be done in a hemodynamically stable patient as well, right? Yes, you can do the laparotomy in a hemodynamically stable patient. Like if you don't have the expertise of the laparoscope, you don't have a laparoscope, due to cost, laparoscope is cost effective, patient is not affording, then you go for the laparotomy. If there is a confirmed more than 3 cm sac, and the fetal heart rate is positive, and there is a bleeding, mild bleeding, then you can go for the laparotomy. If you don't have a expertise and you don't have the laparoscope. Any other question? Okay. Shoulder tip pain. So how the shoulder tip pain occur? When there is a huge amount of the bleeding in the abdomen, so what will happen? The bleeding will be collected into the lower abdomen. Then it will be moved forward up to the upper abdomen. And what will happen? There is a diaphragm above the stomach. Okay. This is the normal anatomy. So when the blood touches the diaphragm, it will irritate the diaphragm. So there is a nerve which causes when the diaphragm is being irritated by the blood, there is a typical shoulder tip pain. The patient is, will you give the typical history of that? I had a one-sided or the other-sided typical shoulder tip pain. This is due to the hemoperitoneum. Okay, any other question? Okay. Any other question? Either you understand or not understand. Everyone understood the ectopic pregnancy? Thank you. Because in Zoom, we can only demonstrate you as much we possible, na? Can do it, na? Not practically. Should we end? What textbook? Ideally, there is a standard book of the 10 teachers. 10 teachers is a standard book for you to read the, should be less than 1,000. Yes. 1,000 or less than 1,000. And sac size should be 2 centimeter, less than 2 centimeter. Okay, should we end the meeting? Can read this topic from Irfan Masood. Irfan Masood is not your textbook. I will not suggest you to read the Irfan Masood. You will do the 10 teachers. And basically, this is a clinical topic. Na? If you have a chance to if you will have a chance to visit the wards, then it can be done practically possible. Ki we can show you the ectopic pregnancy, na? But it is better to read with the 10 teachers. Don't know. I don't have any idea. We don't have any search. Any other sir, right now अभी हमारे पास कोई भी ऐसे knowledge नहीं है. Do you have any other notification? You students have any notification? Not yet. Yes, we also don't have na. You students are the new fourth year reproductive module batch. The new one. Okay. Okay. I think there is no any other question. Should I left it? Should I stop the presentation? Leave the meeting?